Initializing Kumar's Gaming.
Today, we are going to go through one of the very popular games that has taken up the interest of mobile gamers at large. The game's name is Mobile Legends and is made by Moonton. This falls under the category of MOBA games. For the uninitiated, MOBA is the short form of multiplayer online arena, which basically means that MOBA games have a multiplayer online arena in which it has at least more than two players on each party in order to compete with each other. Most of the prominent features one could look when starting this game is its highly defined and detailed artwork. On top of this, these high quality graphics doesn't result in a large software size, rather, the whole game is under 100 megabytes. It seems that Moonton had done enough work in it to optimize the game, as it has to work in low-end devices and poor network quality. However, as we will start to play, we would see that even with these automatic optimizations, there would be a need for more manual tweaks when playing without a Wi-Fi or on a mobile data which is less than 4G. Apart from these artworks, Mobile Legends also holds its tournaments where players of top ranks in the game are taken to compete with each other. The game also has inbuilt gameplay streaming system, although it only works with your default YouTube account and will not work with any of your brand YouTube channels. The in-game streaming system is also prioritized on the level of the gamer's popularity and rank. The game also features in-game voice chat which can be used to talk with your team players in order to coordinate your strategy while battling with the other party. Just to give a heads up, I will not be using this feature since I am doing commentary for the video while this gameplay is recorded. And I would also like to make it clear that even though this feature is provided in the game, no one, at least in the lower level battles, uses this feature to strategize with their team members. And by luck, even if you find anyone speaking your language in this playing field, chances are that they would be a nutcase rude enough for you to rage quit the game altogether. To counter these problems though, Moonton has taken extra steps to include rude behavior checking artificial intelligence in the game, which I think also works with the voice chat. Also, other new gamers who are thinking of joining this game, let me warn you first, so you don't get into trouble, that is that the public in chat system doesn't allow you to cuss. If caught, you might be penalized. Other things to be careful while playing this game is your network ping. If you have a network ping of over 250 milliseconds, you might be deemed as idling by the gaming server and will subsequently be penalized. Also, while using tank characters in this game, be sure not to charge on head too much, as that will also result in penalization. To make it more clear, penalization to players are given on their credit points, which is by default is 100. The more low it gets, less will the number of features a gamer would have while playing this game. Moonton also holds various events as shown in this video stream, so that the gamers from all around the world could meet their other fellow gamers. The games also features a lot of in-game rewards which are socially engineered to keep our dopamine levels high. Such as these daily rewards we get to complete various tasks in a day, and they reset when the clock hits midnight. We also get a free chest every 3 hours, so it is highly addictive for any gamers who are very young. The most basic daily reward in this game is a login reward which gives a gamer an experience point of 10. The other ones are for playing a match and another for winning one, of which what I am going to do now. The match which I have decided to play is with an AI, since my network ping is very high and the game has not been tweaked to work properly in this device and in this slow network. In the AI section, I have decided to go in draft picked simple mode, since it will give me all the players as an AI. This I have chosen strategically in order to show what difficulties a gamer could face while playing with a low-end device in a slow network. Also, since I am doing an introductory level playthrough, it is best to get easy opponents in order to show most of the functionality of my player character. The hold, in the wait of getting AI opponents, is around 30 to 45 seconds, depending on the number of gamers playing the game. The wait, although boring and sometimes annoying, can be used to check other in-game related stuff, such as mails or opening any remaining chests, or maybe even going out to preparation for arranging emblems for this match. As you would see in the founded match here that all my opponents, as well as team players, are AI. This ultimately gives us a chance to test out the functionality of our character, of whatever we want to choose it to be, since there will be no other players to snatch our choice from us. The character we are going to choose is Mia. Mia, by her default skin, is a Moonlight Archer. Mia character is especially made to destroy the arena towers. However, we will cover that in our later videos and posts, and for now we will only get the feel of what abilities this character holds for us during a battle. The last change seconds are given if in some cases we want to switch our character due to an incompatible selection by our teammate, or if one of our teammate wants the same character. Now with the last countdowns. The team versus team screen has a special feature if all your teammates are from the same country, that is, it will show your country's flag beside your team panel, during when the arena loads. This arena loading screen is important. If due to any technical glitch, it fails to load or delays in loading, the respective gamer would lose valuable time in the match and might even get penalized for idling. That said, we shouldn't be too hasty also, since after starting the match it takes few seconds to spawn all the characters of the arena. Now before we start cursing Moondin for this arena loading screen, we should look carefully here as we will see that this screen provides valuable in-game tips which would be very useful to any new gamer. When we look at the options given to choose which skill to take from here, we have only two, that is buff, which are moonlight arrows, and another are arrows from sky. It is much wiser to opt for buff here, since, at the start, a gamer would not be likely to be surrounded by opponents where this skill works the most. In top left corner of the screen we have map of the arena, which indicates that we already have opponents at our borders, where our minions are fighting. While attacking enemy minions, we should be careful of not jumping right into the middle of the clash, as Mia is an archer, she attacks best from a distance unless she is using her special skill, which is rain of arrows. From here we could probably guess that the automated controls are set to target the weakest opponent. While this is beneficial if we are attacking in a group and away from the tower, it is counterproductive while fighting solo with a bunch of opponents, as the dying opponent will drag you towards more harm. It is usually better not to be killed when your hit points are low. As an inexperienced player, getting killed takes out a lot of time out of the arena, for the sake of respawning. With every subsequent kills of opponents, whether it be enemy minions, or other opponent player characters, we get more boosts for our skills, which we could add them from the plus sign, given next to the respective skill control button. Doing a manual resurrection is usually better than dying and respawning, as the latter eats up more time. So it is better to look for non-activity window, when your hit points are low, to manually resurrect.
One shot, one kill. An enemy has been slain! You can't run from my eyes.
When running away from a tussle like this, the best way to do it is to hold back and keep firing. This way, we will be able to back down, without giving our enemy even an inch gap, from the firing. On the plus note, this will also inhibit our enemies from advancing further to some extent. In here, one mistake is done by me, that I was locked onto the enemy, while the enemy dragged me to its tower's firing range. Although I said that Mia is designed for destroying towers before, she could only function if the heat of the tower's firing is taken up by one of our minions. This way of backing up towards your tower when hit points are low is best when we have to trap our enemy in a combat.
One shot, one kill. Ally has been slain.
The best attack used by Mia is a combination of buff and inspire skills. In this combination of these two skills, Mia could easily clear out the minions and an opponent quickly. In here again, I have not waited for the minions to take the heat of the tower's fire. This will result in my premature demise. If however, one does find Mia in this situation, it is better to back down and out of the radar of the firing range of the towers and let the minion take heat before launching another attack. One thing I like to mention here is that the more late in a game a gamer dies, the more late it would be for the player character to respawn. While this is another constraint for winning the match, it could be turned on top of his head and be used to die very quickly in the first few seconds of the start of the arena, instead of using the manual resurrection. I will show on how to do this in later videos.
I can handle that.
In this attack to the defense tower, I have let the minion take the heat of its firing, hence this tower would most likely will not be able to withstand my attack. Rain of arrows is best used when there are a lot of opponents ahead or a strong enemy in a very close range. In the attack of second tower as well, I have let the minions take the firing of the defense tower, so, demolishing it will most likely will not be a problem unless a strong opponent comes into this area. It seems a strong player has come to this area to play. The surfer is a character which travels very fast, so its merits are that it could launch a very strong attack and then move away quickly to dodge the incoming attacks from the enemy. Even if I would have ran, Mia would not be able to match the speed of this character. A safety step could have been taken here by me is that I would have called other members of my team before launching an attack on the inner defense towers of our enemy. But since all my teammates are AI, it would be flaky enough to trust on them that they would respond to my call of gathering here. As we have just seen, the surfer was already able to destroy the mid lane turret and slain one of our allies. This is quite indicative that this character is quite strong to deal with Mia alone. Hence, I called for a backup in hopes that this be able to call my AI allies in this area of the arena. It should be noted that even if the opponents are killed by your allies, we still get a boost to our special skills. A thing regarding our special skill I would like to discuss is that not to opt for a boost of invisibility, which is the third special skill in this set, since that will do no good during a battle. Once we start to attack, invisibility has less of a use as the point of attack is already known for a non-AI player character to attack. However, if you could find any good use of this skill, please do not hesitate to comment about it in the comment section. It looks like we are gaining some ground in this match now. However, the surfer is still relentless and ruthless in slaying our allies. We are now able to see some lag as we have not done the extra tweaks needed to run over a slow internet bandwidth and a low-end device.
One shot, one kill. Our turret is under a droid turret. Watch yourself. An enemy has been slain.
Another mistake I have done here is that I have headed straight into the main area of enemy before destroying the turret guarding it. This will again result in Mia being slain prematurely. To clarify, while this move was okay if we had a tank character and we were surrounded with our allies, this is a foolish move with Mia though, as she doesn't have that much hit points compared to a tank. In the Weight of the Resurrection, we also have an option to view our character's death replay. With its death replay, we could get valuable insights on what mistakes we did and try not to repeat those mistakes further. However, we are not going to view this right now as the game is not tweaked enough to run in this environment properly. Even though the lags are pushing us back, a presence of our AI ally is helping us to move forward. From the above screen messages and arena announcements, we could very well perceive that the enemies are dominating now. Destruction of our turret and slaying of our enemy are also announced for our convenience. Here, Mia was able to destroy the turret easily using the same techniques discussed before. The twist here is that an assassin of our enemy was not far away. Assassins of the game, especially ones like these, are quick to attack and their blows are strong, so Mia will not stand a chance in a close-range combat. As we could see here, during the near end of the match, the resurrection time is 30 seconds. Quite long, at least in my opinion, for this heated time of the battle. A quick strategy is to call your allies even after you are dead, so as to not to let your enemies advance forward on the lane you were previously guarding. This is now, nearly is the end of this arena match. If you are the type of gamer who is not patient enough to run towards the battle area, I would like to suggest to choose some characters such as a sorceress or the surfer who has bothered us much in this match. These characters don't walk, rather, they levitate, hence, they are faster in reaching at battle area once resurrected. In the last moments, even though I am diving straight into a tussle, I am trying to take out as much enemies as possible, with my Rain of Arrows skill, so that my allies and minions are able to destroy the main turret. After a victory of a match, we get some credit points as rewards, which will eventually be used when some problems occur during any future play of this game. In score screen layout of the match, we have an option to like any of our allies or opponents we deem that played well. After the battlefield is cleared in the background, we also get an option to chat with our players who have played with us during this match. The system of this game is quite automated, so when it detects from your GPS or IP address that you are in a specific country, it will ask for the game language to be changed to your regional language. Now, coming on to its settings, the tweaks we need to do are battlefield optimization, low resolution optimization and colorblind mode optimization, that is, if you are colorblind. One thing though, even with all this information, we still have not covered the full guide of on how to play with Mia. Lastly, we need to claim the daily rewards, for which we have played and won this match. That's the end of our video for Mobile Legends. Be sure to come back again for watching another one of our videos on this game.
Well, maybe this is an opportunity to pivot. Thank you.